My name is Gina Fahira and I'm majoring in political science at Universitas Pajajaran. As one of these ISMA recipients, I had an opportunity to be able to study at the Universitat Pompeu Fabra, located in Barcelona, Spain for one trimester. At EPF, we are enrolled in the BABIS course, which studies about interdisciplinary studies. But before that, for those who don't know about the ISMA program or Indonesian International Students Mobility Awards, you guys can check their website at kampusmerdeka.kemendikbud.go.id. Okay, so in this video, I will share my experience of becoming an ISMA awardee starting from the pre-departure process, during my arrival, and then during and after my studies. First of all, I heard about ISMA program from an announcement made by one of my friends. I'm very excited because since my freshman year, I've always wanted to do an exchange program or something like study abroad. But it was very challenging time for me as I had to prepare all the necessary requirements like administration files and essays while also going through the final exams and my internship program. However, thankfully, I managed to pass all the tests. But if any of you think that the challenging times are over, you guys are wrong. Because in the COVID-19 situation, we are facing the unknown. And in our case, and probably many other universities are facing the same problem, which is applying for our visa. Since PPKM was implemented at the time, the embassy wasn't open due to the government regulation, which made us very concerned. But again, in the case of ISMA UPF, we were able to complete all the needs on time and had our flight on September 16. In Spain, we don't need to be quarantined, so as soon as we arrived, we went straight to our housing. And talking about cultural differences between Indonesia and Spain, of course there are some. First, in Spain, people have breakfast around 10 until 11 a.m., lunch around 2 until 3 p.m., and dinner at 9 until 10 p.m., which is very different from us. Second, they also have siesta. So, basically siesta is when some businesses, like restaurant, are closed for a few hours in the afternoon for lunch and or take a short nap. Usually, siesta time is between 2 until 5 p.m. But there are also those that are 4 until 7 p.m. And not every restaurant are closed. It often depends on the area. Like, if you are in the touristy area, it shouldn't be much a problem. And the third one, every Sunday, everything like restaurant, supermarket, shopping center, and others are closed. And my advice for you is you better buy all the necessity the day before. As I mentioned earlier, we are enrolled in the BAPIS course where we have to take 3 or 4 courses out of total 10 courses that EPF offers. I took first, Cinematic Creativity in Spain, Authorship, Industry and Politics. Second, Globalization, Human Development and Sustainability, Politics and Policies in the Framework of the 2030 Agenda. Third one, The Collectivity, Revolution, Building a Global Community. And the last one, the LGBT+, Exploring Identities and Diversity. From my observation, there are 6 learning methods used by lecturers at EPF, which are compulsory or mandatory reading, seminars, class discussion, debates, group project, and field trip. This is very different from my home university, but maybe because international students are more actively involved in the class discussion and starting debates. And as for compulsory reading, it did change my study habit, because we are required to read it and study it, or else in the next class, we won't be able to fully understand what the lectures teach us. But the most important thing that I like is that the lecturer always give us feedbacks for our assignment, midterm, and final, no matter how many people they have to give that feedback. So for sure, I really hope that in Indonesia, the lecturer will also provide that kind of feedback or input so that we can really learn what mistakes we made or our strong point. And so far, since I've had an online meeting with my major at home university while in Barcelona and told them about these learning methods at EPF, I hope that there will be a changes in the implementation for the better. Anyways, I'll close this video. I'm officially Isma Bias because I've built my dream through this experience. Isma, be bold to go abroad. See you!